I'm fine and missing you a lot. Let's start our class with the prayer. Join your hands, close your eyes and get ready for prayer. Om Bhuvasvah Tatsavitulvarenam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyo Yonaha Prachodayat. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Let's start our class with a new hope. Today I have written one good thought. How many of you are able to see here? Who can read
it? If you have a good thought, then shine out of your face.
Is it the right way? Two people are reading together. Only one.
If you have good thought, they will shine out of your face like sunbeams, and you will always look lovely.
Very good. Yes. Means what is the meaning of the good thought?
Ma'am,
if
ma'am, can
you
I
have
say?
Yes.
Ma'am, if we have a good thought, ma'am, then we have no any bad idea, and our face shine like sunflower's beam, and our face always look lovely.
Good. Means the morning sunbeams are very refreshing. Sunbeams means Surya Kiran, right? They are very refreshing, and in the morning the sun looks like smiling, and it provides enrich our morning with positivity. So that if you are having good thoughts, so your face will be always smiling, right? You will smile whole day with positivity, and this positivity will help people to live joyfully. Okay. Now, here is one word. What is the word?
If.
It is all about if. Agar aapke paas good thought the, if. Okay. Second thing, I want to give you one short experience, right? How many of you are here? A few of you can on your camera. We will do one action. Yes? Okay? I'm having a very short, I can't say it for poem, but it is like a poem, okay? Now, Rushil is here. Anyone else? How are you, Rushil? How are you feeling now? Better?
Fine, ma'am.
Okay, take care. See, now I am having, you have to do the action, right? If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands. Done? Okay, show me. If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands. Yes? If you are happy and you know it, say cheese. Yes?
Ma'am, this we had done in third standard.
Yes, Suhani. But when you did it, you took it as a poem. Right, Suhani?
Yes,
Suhani,
ma'am.
On your camera.
Ma'am, wait. In this one, it is not coming. So I'm joining from another.
Okay, fine. So see here, this is all about if. Agar aap happy ho, then clap your hands. Right. Today, we are going to learn the importance of if in our day-to-day communication. Today, we are going to learn about if importance. It is about F-I-R-S-T, first and second conditional. Chapter number 5. First and second conditional, chapter number 5. Today's topic, first conditional and beta, Ashish sir told me that he will take, right? This Ashish sir, you can ask him. And Second conditional. What? Second conditional. Okay. We have learned about clauses. Here, what is the main topic? Clauses. C-L-A-U-S-E-S. Okay. Who will tell me what is a clause? Who will tell me what is a clause?
Clauses are incomplete words.
Wrong. No. Clause is the, see here, I'm going to explain you clause one more time. I thought that's why I tried to refresh you people. C-L-A-U-S-E. Okay. Clause. I think a group of related words. A clause is a group of related words. First thing. Second thing, it has a subject and a verb. Then it has a complete meaning. This is what you have learned in 6th standard. Have you learned it in 6th standard? Phrases and clauses and types of phrases, prepositional phrase, adverb phrase, adjective phrase. Do you remember it? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, today we are going to learn about if clauses. What? If clauses. Okay. Then, first and second only. But in actual, there are how many types of clauses? Zero conditional, first conditional, second conditional, third conditional, and mixed conditional. Right. Now, see here. Let me shift the phone for a while so that you people will get clear idea. Okay, do you have any confusion about clauses? I think now you will not have. This is what we learned in 6th standard, right? Now, today, we are going to learn about if clauses. For this, we need two things. Clear idea of clause and tenses. How many tenses are there? There are three main tenses, right? How many tenses are there? There are three main tenses. What are they? Present, past, and future. We have also learned about the tenses in 6th standard, 5th standard, 3rd standard. Now, we are using tenses and clause knowledge to learn about for if clauses, first and second conditional, right? There are how many types? Conditionals are having 5 types. What are they? First, zero conditional. Then, FIRST, first conditional. Then, speak up beta. Then, second conditional. Third conditional. Then, mixed conditional. Okay. Again, I am telling you something. Be attentive. In seventh standard, you are learning only two. These two are main for you, right? And in eighth and ninth standard, you will learn the remaining one, right? These two are important according to our syllabus. These two we are going to learn today. But I'm going to explain you these three also in basic form, right? So that it will help you to differentiate or understand what are the first and second clauses. So which things we are going to learn today? Today we are going to learn about what are our today's learning outcomes?
Yes. First and second conditional.
Yes. What do we learn? How, what things you will be able to do after learning this whole, you will be able to understand. understand and use conditional clause in day-to-day life, right? This is our learning outcome. Today we will learn this thing. Okay, we will be able to identify the clause, which kind of clause it is. Then we will be able to understand and use conditional clauses in our day-to-day life. I have explained you lot of things. Now today, listen carefully my explanation. Why? Because I am going to use so many sentences based on the conditional. Right. Now let's start with the PPT.
Okay. Wait for a while. Now see here, we are going to start the PPT. I hope that you find it interesting. See here, conditional. I hope that it is visible here to you. Now see, conditionals, okay? First, what are the conditionals? Let me explain you. Conditionals mean the first part of the sentence is a condition and second one it is present. I am going to explain you. If you practice hard, you will be the way. What is the first part? If you practice hard, means this is the condition. Okay, and you will be the way of the result. What is the condition? अगर तुम practice ज्यादा करते हो तो जीत जाओगे, right? Part is always the condition and second part is main clause. It is always the result of if clause. Right? Now, any doubt till now? Now, please, if you have any confusion about conditionals, I hope you will not. Now, see here, let me take it little bit back so that it will get clear. Yes. Now, are you able to see the screen here? Is it visible properly?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Now let me check the classroom for a while. It is all our 16 students. Okay. Now see here the slide of the. Wait. See here zero condition. What is the zero condition clause? If you don't water flowers, they die. Okay. Let me do one minute. If you don't water flowers, they die. What will happen if you don't water flowers? This is the if clause. Okay? This is the if clause. It is the condition. If you don't water flowers, then what will happen? They die. This is the result. See here, if you don't water is the simple present. This one is also simple present. Got it? Okay. If you have a headache, stop watching TV. What is the condition? Agar tumhara dard ho raha hai. So what should be in future? Stop watching TV. This one is the advice. We use zero condition for to express general rules or advice. See here, present simple. Both have present simple. So what is the structure? In zero conditional clause, if plus simple present plus simple present. Both are imperative sentences. What are the imperative sentences? Who will tell me? I have explained you in previous class also. Fifth standard also. What are called the imperative sentences? Yes? Speaker better, we are not having for the friend. Zero conditional, what is the imperative? Imperative sentences are the general advices or instructions. They usually start with a verb. What is the criteria? What is the main characteristic of the imperative sentence? sentence. Okay, you have learned this in fifth standard. That's why I am telling you people, we are in you in the sense of grammar. Again, I am telling you, these clauses are the most important part of grammar. Because in our day-to-day life, we need to communicate, right? And for good communication, we need to be clear about the concept and use of clause. Now, do you have any doubt in conditional clause, zero conditional clause? Yes? Yes? Speaker Petra? Any doubt or query?
No, ma'am, no doubt.
Okay. Now, see here, next part, it is all about first conditional. First conditional is important according to our syllabus. That's why we attend you and listen it carefully. What is our conditional clause? If the weather is nice, we will go for a walk. If the weather is nice, we will go for a walk. Second, if you don't apologize, she will never talk to you again. Here, if plus simple present. Right, there this is about future, right? Future tense. Okay, better if you don't apologize, okay? Simple present tense, negative sentence. Here, she will never trust you, future tense, negative sentence, never. This is the reaction, return of this action. This is the action, condition, and this one is the result. If it rains heavily, if it rains heavily, we will organize a rain dance party. Okay? So this kind of thing. Here, what is the structure? It's for present simple. Here, when for future simple. Okay? Just if. Now, see here, the use of first condition. If the first conditional refers to the present and future. Present and future. Okay. It expresses possible conditions. Possible conditions and probable results in the future. If you don't practice for handwriting, you will never score good marks in the language paper or any paper. Why? Because practicing handwriting is essential skill for students. And if you don't practice, then what happens? You will not get good marks. Understood? Now, what is the structure here? We are speaking about first conditional. What is the structure of first conditional? Tell me. If plus simple present plus simple future, right? Teacher, yes or no, something. Then what is the use? Possible condition? Possible condition and it's probable result. It's probable result. Okay. Now see here, the next, do you have any doubt in this one? Zero conditional, possible conditional, any doubt is ready? Speak up better. Now see here, second conditional clause. What is the second conditional clause? Here, instead of, okay, Jack wants to buy a house, but he can't do this because he doesn't have any money. Now, if I had a lot of money, I would buy a big house. Now, I want to buy a car. Jyoti wants to buy a car, but she can't do this because she doesn't have any money. Right? Now, if I had a lot of money, I would buy a
conditional and first conditional.
Yes, I will explain it. Now listen this carefully. Okay, let me finish first slide, then I will explain. Because this is also the part of explanation. After this slide, we are going to know difference between first conditional and second conditional and third conditional. Right? So be attentive. Now, if I have this number, I will call him. I want to visit Suhani's house. Okay, but I can't. Why? Because I don't have her address. So, if I give Suhani's address, I would visit her. Now see the structure. See the main slide of cross second conditional cross. Second conditional clause is dealing with the past simple tense. Simple past is that would plus infinitive. Right. Example, let's see here. Main clause, present conditional. If I had a lot of money, I could buy a big house. If I had a lot of money, if I knew. Okay. So here, no, new, no. What are the four? No, new, no. This is the past participle. This is the simple past, okay? And this is the best form. This is the forms of the words. You have learned it. Yes or no? Are you able to form the three parts of words? Three. Okay, reply it beta. Now see here, past simple tense and present conditional. Example, the second conditional refers to the present and future. It expresses a particular situation and its probable result. Okay, now the situation or condition is improbable, impossible, imaginary or contrary to known fact. Here, what is the structure of second conditional clause? Second conditional clause. What is the structure of second conditional clause? Is plus past simple or simple past plus would plus base form of verb. Of work. And what is the use of it? We can use it to express unreal situations. Unreal situations. Right. Now I will give you an example. And it's probable result. And it's probable result. Example, if I had a car, I would drop you to the market. अगर मेरे पास कार होती तो मैं तुम्हें मार्केट छोड़ देता. Right? Here, what is the unreal situation? I am not having car. If I had a laptop, I would explain you with voice plus screen share. Right? This is all about the unreal situation and its probable result. And what is the difference between first conditional and second conditional? You will get it in slide, but let me explain it to you in short. And see here, first conditional, we use first conditional about the possible conditions. अभी ये होगा तो इसका ये एक्शन होगा राइट. इफ आई डोंट पुट माय फोन फॉर चार्जिंग अवर क्लास विल गेट डिस्कनेक्ट. यस ओनली 22% बैटरी राइट. सो हियर इफ आई डोंट पुट माय फोन फॉर चार्जिंग देन इट विल गेट स्विच ऑफ. यस this is the real situation. I am speaking about the possible condition and probable action. And here I am speaking about a real situation. The real thing is if I drag a lot of water, then I would say okay, so it is about the real situation. What is happened before while? Right now, this is about second clause. Now, third condition. Let me change the slide. It's first person, second conditional. Now, see here. If John runs fast, he will win the race. This is still possible to happen. Now, if John ran fast, he would win the race. Here, this is unlikely to happen because John doesn't run fast. What is the ability of John? He does not run fast. Okay. Now, the difference between first and second condition. Both conditions refer to the present and future. Both refer to the present and future. What's the difference? The difference is about probability, not time. First condition, real and possible situation. And second condition, unlikely to happen and unreal situation. Okay. Now, any doubt in this case? I hope that it is clear to you. Now, next slide. It is all about third condition. Jack wanted to buy a house last year, but he couldn't do that because he didn't have any money. If I had a lot of money, I would have bought a big house. Present, past perfect. See here the example now. Yesterday, Uma wanted to phone Paul, but she couldn't do that because she didn't know his number. If I had known his number, I would have phoned him. Okay. Now see the structure and all these things. It is all about past perfect. Simple. Okay, past perfect. And here, would have the past continuous. See here, if I had, here, this one is for past perfect. If I had a lot of money, I would have bought a big house. Would have the buy, bought, what? Okay, now. See here, if I had known his number, I would have phoned him. I would have phoned him. Have perfect. Okay, now, third conditional refers to the past and it is not based on fact. It expresses a situation which is contrary to reality in the past. Now, see, this is what we learned about. What? This is what we learned about. Okay. Now, see here, I will send this PPT to you. But before this, now see here, what we have, am I audible to you? Am I audible to you?
Ma'am, your screen is bigger.
Yes, beta, it is because of just charging. I am going to put my phone for charging. But before this, listen it carefully. We learn about zero conditional. It is all about the general truth or advice, right? Now see, I am going to put my phone for charging so that it will not affect our class. Then after we are going to start the exercise of textbook. Open textbook exercise. Hurry up, page number 69. Now see here, I am going to read the question for you people. Okay, you have to tell me the answer.
Right,
ma'am, screen become blur.
Yes, Vetra, wait. It will not get now.
Okay. Now, I hope that it is clear for everyone.
Am I visible?
Yes, ma'am, now coming.
Wait, ma'am. Now wait. Wait for a while, huh? Wait for a while, huh? Open page number. Am I visible to you people?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see here, read these sentences. Okay. If you will be sorry, if you won't take me to the, you will be sorry if you won't, if you don't take me to the place. Wait for a while, beta. Today it is about network connection also. Now see, now am I visible clearly to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In your textbook, page number 59 in your textbook. Okay, now, see the exercise one. Complete these sentences with the correct forms of the verbs in the bracket. If you come home late, I will be angry. Now, question number 2. Red house dashed into the finals. If yellow house dashed this match, what is it about? It is about zero conditional. Red house will go into the finals if yellow house loses this match. Do you want to see it in textbook or you will be able to write the answers by dictation only?
Ma'am,
can I ask you the answer?
Yes.
Yes, everyone. Okay. Wait for a while. I will show you, right? Wait for a while. Now see here. It is all about the answer. The terms of the word. If you come. I will be angry now. If you lose this match, we eat this entire cake, we will sing. If the weather dash, we will dash the picnic. Who will answer the fourth question? Yes.
Ma'am, your voice is cutting and screen is also about blur.
Yes, ma'am. Voice is cutting and screen is blur.
Yes. It is for the right? See, now I'm showing you again. I hope that you people will get clear here. Wait for a while.
Now see, now is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now is now see, if the weather does not improve, we will not have the picnic. Fifth one, if you dash, you dash the bus. If you don't hurry, you will miss the bus. Okay? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you finished till
the
now is it okay?
What, ma'am?
I will send you PDF also, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Now see the next part. The second conditional, okay? I have explained you, is used to talk about situation that is unlikely to happen or is imaginary. Example, if I told her the truth, she would hate me. I would sleep late if I were an adult. Now, verb in if clause, past tense. And verb in the main clause, would plus verb, base form of the verb. See here? If I had a pet, I would take great care of it. See, first, see. Second, I would go to the cinema if I had the time. F, second, F. Third, if Meena were here, she would sing you a song. Fourth, E. No, fourth, third, D. Okay, now. Fourth, I would be grateful if you helped me carry my luggage. Fourth, E. Now, fifth, if Malika knew Leela, she would invite her home. Okay, now, sixth, if I were in Chennai, I would visit my grandfather. Again, I am going to read the whole sentence for you. First, let me explain you the sequence first. First, C, second, F, third, D, fourth, E, fifth, B, sixth, A. Now see the answer. First, if I had a pet, I would take care of it. Second, I would go to the cinema if I had the time. Third, if Meena were here, she would sing a song. She would sing you a song. Now, fourth one, I would be grateful if you helped me carry my luggage. Five, if Malika knew Leela, she would invite her home. Six, if I were in Chennai, I would visit my grandfather. This is how we finished the exercise A and B of textbook. Now see here in detail, again I am reading it for you. These are the conditional. What are the conditionals? If we will be sorry, you will be sorry if you don't take me to the play. Now, if Amy died, it would be my fault. These sentences are conditional. Conditionals are sentences which have two parts. One part states a condition that is necessary for the event in the other part to occur. If you are late, you won't be able to attend the meeting. If clause, main clause. If I won the lottery, I would go to Europe. Okay, now, use commas. If clause is at the beginning of the sentence. If I had a car, I would not take the bus. Do not use comma if the if clause is at the end of the sentence. I would go to the concert if you came with me. I hope that it is clear to you. See, do you have any doubt in this conditional, first or second conditional, if conditional? Yes, everyone.
No,
any
ma'am.
Doubt in this?
No, ma'am.
Tell me what are the zero conditional. Zero conditional is the structure of zero conditional is plus simple present plus simple present. It is useful to explain a general truth or to give advice to someone. Right. What is first conditional? We use first conditional with the probable condition and its probable result. Okay. Situation. Probable. What will happen? And the structure is if plus simple present tense plus simple future. Okay, in general we use first conditional to speak about the probable condition and its probable reason. Now second conditional, what is the structure of second conditional? Is plus past simple plus would plus base form of the verb. Okay, it is like it is used unlikely to happen the situation. Okay, or unreal situations and its probable reason. This is what we learned about the clauses here. Now, tell me if you are having any difficulty in these two. I will send you the PPT, the same PPT, so that you will find it interesting to get more information about the clauses. Any doubt till now?
No, ma'am, no doubt.
Okay. Now today you are having one homework. You have to solve grammar question A and B in worksheet and workbook both of chapter 5. Okay, the conditional question in workbook and worksheet both. You will get a PDF so that you will find it little bit easy to cross check your answers. Okay. Now see one more thing, you are having marks for the submission. So before, till PA1, if you were lazy, then please be attentive. Again I am telling you, try to complete your day's work before the day ends, right? Then it will help you to be complete with the writing work.
Ma'am, when our result is coming?
Yes. In this work, we need to work. In this work, we need to work hard. Okay. And be attentive. Try to attend each and every class. Because nowadays, all the teachers are teaching by keeping the exam in mind. So don't waste your time. Try to attend your class every day. Okay. Now, you can leave the class. Have a good day. Bye-bye. I hope that today's class you find it interesting. Yes,
yes
or no,
ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
It was very interesting.
Okay. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Bye, ma'am. Have a nice day.
Bye, Bitu. Bye.